Hey guys, it's Vanessa, and I'm doing my second video for spring 2014, and I cleaned out my closet and I went to the mall, so there's a couple of stuff that I want to show you guys. It's not that much, but you know, it's spring, so this is like the fun time of fashion. So I'm just going to show you guys. I'm going to start by American Apparel and go to different stores. So first, I have this neon green dress, cutout dress, and it costs $52, and I love how it has the cutouts on the sides, and I love how it's backless. So you can wear this with like a bandeau, or you can wear it with like an undershirt, or you can wear it without a bra. And I went on the American Apparel website and I saw that they were wearing it with collared t-shirts, like collared shirts like this. And it didn't look that bad as it sounds, but it actually looked kind of cute. So here's a neon green dress. And neon green was all over the spring runways. And I'm gonna put a post about that soon on my blog about neon colors being in as well as pastel colors. So there's this dress. Next is bathing suit season. I've had this. I bought this last year, it's $28, and it's a high-waisted nylon bathing suit bottom, and I also got this at American Apparel, and you can pair it with a red triangle bathing suit top, a bandeau bathing suit top, leopard, you know, this is like a fun way to have fun with this. You can pair with like, you know, black, leopard, red, etc. So there's that. And it's high-waisted, which is pretty mostly everything in my closet. So it's that. Next is just bustier crop tops. They cost $32. So I have a white one, and I also have a black one. And crop tops, everybody knows it's in. I feel like everybody's wearing them, which is good. I just don't want the trend to fade away because spring is pretty much getting started, and summer's coming up too as well, so hopefully it doesn't go away. And even if it does, you can still wear your crop tops out with your high-waisted shorts or skirts. So these each cost $32. So there's that. And then we have this striped dress from American Apparel, which is $42, and it has like a cute corset in the front, and it's like one of those party dresses. It's like short and tight, and if you're self-conscious like me sometimes, you can wear it with like an oversized cardigan, or you can wear it with like a leather jacket, maybe tights under or thigh highs. And you can always turn like a skimpy dress into like a not skimpy dress. So there's that. And it looks like cool, like if you're going to like a rock and roll concert, or like, you know, I just think it's really cute and like edgy. So there's that. And I think that's it for the American Apparel section. Yeah. So we're gonna move on to the Forever 21 section. And I got shorts after shorts after shorts at Forever 21 because there were such good deals. They were each under $15 each. So I got this one, and in the back, I love how the back has a zipper in the back and the two pockets. It's not just like a regular black cuff short. And then I had these shorts before. This one. And this was $14.80, the other one was $14.80. So these are more loose. And then the faux leather shorts, $15.80. Oh, yep. And I love how even though they're all black, which is like my favorite color to wear, they're all different, like their own way. Like this one's more edgier. This one's more like, you know, like more loose, you can move around in it. And this just one is just like simple, hang out with your friends, go to the mall type shorts. So I love how they're all different in like their own ways, even though they're the same color. And next, here is this tribal dress. This one was $15.80. And I love it because of the print. I don't have too many clothes that have prints on it. But this dress, it was such a good deal and I had to buy it. And I love the length. I don't know if you can see it really well, but it's like maybe a little bit below the knee. And I don't really have too many dresses that are below the knee. They're usually above the knee. But this one was really cute and the print is really loud, so try pairing it with like basic jewelry, not to anything that's like flashy, because the dress speaks for itself already. So there's that from Forever 21. And this white dress, you probably saw it on my Instagram. I wore it for Easter. And I love how it's long sleeve. I love long sleeve dresses. And I love how it has the deep V in the front. That's really cool. And the thing is that this is a large and I'm an extra small, and this was the last one, and I was in desperate need of an Easter dress. So I went to the fitting room, tried it on, put a belt over it. It looked amazing. So I just goes to show you don't really have to buy everything in your size. You can always buy a size up and like put a belt over it, and it can really look really chic and sophisticated. So I'm actually glad I went with the large and I didn't find the extra small, because it turned out great. So there's this, and this was $20. 1980, so pretty much $20. Okay, and then I went to Zara and I bought this dress. It's just a simple black dress. Yeah, it's just a simple black dress for like, you know, just in case like an interview or like a cocktail party. I feel like every girl needs a black dress. I don't think, oh, actually I do have one, but you know, you can never have enough. So there's that. And we're gonna move on to like the vintage thrift store boutique section. And here is the skirt. I bought the skirt maybe 2 years ago, and I think I've only worn it once. And that's when I used to love wearing skirts, but now like I'm kind of over skirts and I like wear more shorts now. So here's just the skirt. It's still a fun skirt. I love the polka dots. I love the bow in the front. I suggest if you do wear skirts like this that are short and that don't have shorts under it, to wear shorts under it, because you can definitely have a Marilyn Monroe moment where the wind blows, and yeah, that's not a pretty sight. So I suggest you wear like shorts under it. So there's that. And another crop top, just a simple crop top, and it ties in the front. You know, I would wear these with like my white high-waisted shorts for like a picnic or something. And another trend that's going on that I love is the denim on denim trend. And I feel like that's really cool, like 90s vibe to it, which I love. So I kind of got this like faux denim shirt. And when you pair it with like denim jeans, it gives it like this like cool vibe. And I wore that to the mall, and that was like, I put that on Instagram recently too. And it was just like, you know, I felt great in it because I love denim. So you guys should start wearing the denim on denim trend. And I went to Charlotte Russe and I bought these shoes for $30. And what I love about them is that they are reminiscent to my black Manolo Blahniks. And the difference between them are that these are more comfortable than the other ones. And you know, you should always have a shoe that's gorgeous but still comfortable at the same time. And even though those shoes were gorgeous, they weren't comfortable, so I'm glad I got the best of both worlds with these. And I love the Mary Jane strap. It makes you your legs look longer. So, and the heel is not too high, so it's like really, really comfortable. I lasted all day and then without complaining. So $30 at Charlotte Russe. And lastly, I feel every girl should have a boyfriend tee. Boyfriend button down tee or a regular tee. And here's this one. And this one I got from a thrift store. And what I love about it is the colors. I think the colors are perfect for the spring. And with the boyfriend tees, you can either wear it, like, you know, just throw it on without buttoning it up. and wear it with like shorts, or you can actually tie it around your shorts. Not with the shirt that I'm wearing right now, but with like a plain shirt, since this has already stripes on it. But you can wear it like that, or you can just throw it on. If you feel like your shorts are too short, you just throw it on and it kind of covers everything in the back. So that's what I love about this. And the thing is that you don't have to, you know, go to the store and buy a boyfriend tee. You know, you can borrow it from like your dad or your older brother or your older cousins that are brothers, whatever. Or, you know, if you want, just go to the guy section at any store and just get a regular button down tee. So that's what I got. Or you can go like to the thrift store like me and get it. They have so many to choose from. I suggest you do that as well. So that is pretty much it. And thank you guys for watching. And I will be posting more soon. And I'm going to the mall in a couple days to go out there and interview. Well, not interview, but like ask people at the mall questions, mostly girls around my age, questions about what are they looking forward to in the spring as far as like trends and things like that. What's your favorite trends? And like what do you like to wear for the spring? And that's my first time doing that. I'm really, really excited about that. And if you guys are wondering what I'm wearing, I actually made these shorts last year. And then this is just an example of a pastel color. I put a post about this on my blog, and I love how it color blocks as well. So it's that. And this hat, I got it from my mom's closet. And I'm so happy I found it, because I seen these at Topshop, Forever, H&M, and I never got the chance to buy it. I don't know why. But I'm glad that I didn't buy it, because my mom had one sitting in her room the whole time. So she's not getting this back. So I'll probably buy her another one for like Mother's Day or something. But thank you guys for watching, and follow Tumblr, you know, my Instagram, my website, my Twitter, my blogs, everything. You guys know the links, and I'll post them again. And thank you guys for watching, and I will see you guys soon.